PLA is still the most common 3D printing material, but often not suitable for every application due to its brittleness and bad thermal performance. Modified PLAs, known under the name PLA+, Tough PLA or Impact PLA, claim to tackle some of these downsides. I thoroughly compared regular and modified polylactic acid in terms of printability, strength, stiffness, impact resistance, and thermal behavior. So is it worth spending the extra dollar for those materials? Let's find out more. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. Regular PLA is really easy to print and stronger than some might expect, though if a PLA part actually fails, it shatters quite violently. During the last years, many companies brought modified PLA filaments onto the market that claimed to improve on those downsides, up to the point that some even call their modified PLA eco-ABS. Have you ever used modified PLA, and how was your experience? Let's discuss down in the comments. There is not one PLA Plus or Tough PLA, so I can't compare all of them. But I received a roll of Polymaker's PolyLite PLA, which I call a regular PLA, and a roll of their Polymax PLA, which is the modified version, which I'll use to represent PLA+. I thought this is a great opportunity to finally compare those two materials. The results will not 100% match with any other brand, but we'll see really clear trends. There are several ways to toughen up a PLA base resin, and every manufacturer probably adds their own 11 herbs and spices. In general, most of the time, additives and modifiers are added, and the materials also often get compounded, so mixed with other materials like elastomers to dial in the properties. The safety data sheets the manufacturers should provide can sometimes give us a slight idea of what's going on. And the Polymax PLA, for example, contains a significant amount of acrylic polymers. In contrast, the standard PolyLite PLA is basically only PLA, with only a minor amount of additives. So let's first take a look at the price, because manufacturers do usually charge quite a bit extra for the modified materials. Polymaker's PolyLite PLA is decently priced at $30 per kilo, whereas the Polymax variant is almost $45 for a roll of only 750 grams. That results in double the price and, in the end, $60 per kilo. I checked some other brands, and also there the markup is between 5 to 40%. So let's next try to find out if it's worth paying the extra charge for what we're getting. First, I printed a bunch of quality test parts to see if the print results differ. I dried both spools after I took them out of the box to not run into trouble with moisture in the material. I removed 0.16% and 0.23% of moisture, which is not a lot, and I don't think that any of the spools took up a considerable amount of water while being packed. Both printed without a problem, though in later prints I've seen a little more warping on the regular PLA parts, where the modified PLA parts printed and stuck flawlessly. The higher modified PLAs often include additives that help with build plate adhesion and also reduce warping, so it might sometimes be easier to print, especially for big warp-prone parts. The nozzle temperature was set to 215 degrees for both materials, though some other Tough PLAs might need to be printed a little bit hotter. With the first prints, I checked overhang performance, stringing and small details, as well as bridging. The regular PLA showed a bit more stringing, which was a little surprising to me because I rather had this problem with other PLA Plus spools in the past. Still, both materials were able to reproduce the really fine tips of the spikes. Bridging performance was basically the same for both, and even the 70mm gap still looked great. Overhang performance was slightly better with the regular PolyLite PLA. The 65 degrees overhang of the Polymax PLA part already looked a bit rough, whereas it still looked okay with the other filament. The 3D Benchy confirmed the findings, and I was able to also spot some more stringing on the PolyLite PLA parts. Another thing I noticed with the Polymaker materials, and also with other brands, is that standard PLA usually results in glossy prints, the modified version often is a bit more matte. All in all, the printing performance of both the materials is very similar, and you should expect the same when switching from normal PLA to a PLA Plus. Let's now take a look at the mechanical performance that I checked with my mini tensile test specimens, a bending bar for stiffness evaluation, as well as my usual test hook and impact test samples. Before we do that, make sure that you're subscribed if you learn something from these investigations. There have been some, let's say, changes in my life, which might lead to a less regular schedule. So also select the notification bell to not miss any upcoming videos. Let's first take a look at the tensile strength and layer adhesion. Many are not aware that in terms of static strength, PLA is still one of the strongest materials that you can print on a home machine, with basically only PC that beats it. That is also confirmed by my tensile specimens. PolyLite samples that were printed lying were able to bear 57 MPa of stress, but did fail quite abruptly and violently. The layer adhesion samples also performed remarkably good, with a maximum strength of 43 MPa, which is still 75% of the regular strength. Most other materials usually show at least a 50% knockdown factor. This is definitely something I have to praise PolyMaker for, because even though the PolyLite material is affordable and not hugely modified, it is a solid filament. Now it becomes interesting, because the PolyMax PLA, and similarly other modified PLAs, was not as strong as the regular stuff. The lying samples failed at 43 MPa on average, which is significantly weaker than the normal PLA. But why do then all the modified PLAs claim that they are stronger? Well, if we take a look at how the samples fail, we see a remarkable difference. PolyMax PLA deforms and yields a huge amount before it fails. The PolyLite PLA just snaps without warning, so even though during slow loading, normal PLA is stronger, most real-world load cases are usually at least a bit dynamic. At loading scenarios where regular PLA will simply snap and fail, the modified material yields, taking up energy and redistributes the loads, and therefore might be more tough. Layer adhesion for PolyMax PLA, by the way, was similarly good as before, and the samples were able to bear a remarkable 75% of the loads compared to the ideally printed ones. Since the parts, only from handling, felt a little different, I also tested them for stiffness using a 3-point bending rig. So I loaded printed bars with increasing weights and recorded the deformation. It was clearly visible that the modified PLA deformed more under the same weight as regular PLA. In numbers, PolyLite PLA has a bending modulus of 3000 MPa, PolyMax only of 2200 MPa. This also means that the modified PLAs can sometimes be only as stiff as PETG or ABS, which have their bending modulus both also at around 2000 MPa, so keep that in mind. Next, I tested my usual test hooks, because those show a bit more realistic loading scenarios than just the axial tensile test bars. Different to other samples, the hooks were not printed fully dense, but with 3 perimeters and 30% infill. Since we again load the part slowly in a quasi-static manner, the PolyLite hook was significantly stronger and broke at 72 kg. The one that I printed standing failed at 44 kg. The PolyMax hook already failed at 48 kg. The one that I printed standing at only 34 kg. Again, we see the massive difference in failure mode, because the regular PLA just snapped, but the modified version absorbed a lot of energy by yielding and didn't even break in the end. Let's now take a look at the impact strength, so the resistance of a material against a short load impulse, for example if you drop a part. The PolyLite samples were, on average, able to absorb 5 kJ per square meter and just snapped right through. PolyMax was around 4 times tougher and mostly didn't break through. The two halves were often still held together by a small bit of material after the test. At last, let's answer the question if the modified PLA behaves better in terms of temperature resistance, So if claims like eco-ABS hold true in that regard. For this investigation, I put two test bars loaded with weights in the middle into my kitchen oven and increased the temperature gradually while monitoring it with a thermocouple. The bars quickly became soft, and you are definitely not able to use them anymore over 60 degrees Celsius. At 65 degrees Celsius, both failed just at the same time. So for the polymaker material, the modified PLA is no more temperature resistant than the simple PolyLite PLA, and that's also probably true for most other PLA Plus or tough PLAs. Though I have to say that there might be some modified PLAs around where crystallization modifiers or other copolymers improve this property. Alright, so what's the verdict after all of these tests? What distinguishes a PLA Plus from a regular PLA? It's usually, and sometimes also understandably, more expensive. Temperature resistance and also print quality is mostly the same. Printability, for example, with a Polymax PLA is definitely improved due to less warping. Static strength is not higher, and also the material stiffness can be significantly lower. Where the modified PLAs shine is the impact behavior, because here they are usually way tougher than their unmodified counterparts, and this also shows in their failure modes. Tough PLA breaks way more predictable because it will significantly deform before it snaps, making it more suitable for some technical applications. So with all of these results, we should ask ourselves if PETG might be a good and cheaper substitute for PLA Plus, because it also has a higher impact resistance, yields more, and even is more temperature resistant. But what do you think?
Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you're all doing well. If you found this video helpful, then leave a like, share it with the community, and make sure that you subscribe for more. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon, become a YouTube member, or use the affiliate links in the description. Go check out my other videos if you currently have more time than usual and want to educate yourself. Stay healthy, auf Wiedersehen, and I hope to see you in the next one.